लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैड कंप्लीटेड चैप्टर 2 and 3, करेक्ट? दैट इज लोकेशन एक्सटेंट एंड फिजियोग्राफी एंड ड्रेनेज. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंप्लीट द अदर चैप्टर्स, दैट इज 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. प्लस वील ऑल्सो बी ड्रॉइंग ग्राफ्स टूडे, राइट? वी आर स्टिल मेकिंग मिस्टेक्स. आई गेस इट्स बीन मोर देन 5 एग्जाम्स दैट वी हैव रिटन, including the unit test and school exams, right? We are still not very confident about graph or map, so we'll discuss those queries also once we are done with discussing the chapters. Map marking, if you have any queries, I'll be revising those. Right, there are certain places which I'll just mention in between that this might be asked for map marking. Please make a note of these places or these topics, okay? Very good evening. We are waiting for 2 more minutes before starting. We are going to start with chapter number 4, that is climate. Sure, Sneha, sure. Don't worry. Okay, let us begin. We are starting with chapter number 4, that is climate. Starting with climate of India. Now, we know that India has a dash type of climate. India has a dash type of climate. Perfect. Monsoon type of climate. Now, talking about the region, peninsula, we know that India receives rainfall from dash monsoon winds. India receives rainfall from dash monsoon winds. Answers in the chat box. Perfect. Southwest monsoon winds, and it also receives rainfall from northeast trade winds. Correct. Southwest monsoon winds will be obstructed by the western ghats. So western coast mein heavy rainfall hota hai. This southwest monsoon winds, when it travels towards Gujarat and Rajasthan, will it be obstructed by Aravali? No. Why? Because the winds are parallel. Perfect. Since the winds are parallel to Aravali ranges, there is no obstruction towards Rajasthan and Punjab, and hence the rainfall over here is very less. Okay, then this wind will travel towards Himalayas. Wahan pe to obstruction hoga. And places like Punjab and the Ganga plain will receive heavy rainfall. Okay, another place which receives heavy rainfall in India is Chirapunji and Mausinram, wettest place in the world. Maximum rainfall yahi pe hota hai pure world mein, more than 11,000 millimeters. On the other side, Shillong will become a rain shadow region. Okay, this was southwest monsoon winds. Phir aata hai northeast trade winds, which will collect water from Bay of Bengal, that is collect moisture from Bay of Bengal. It will be obstructed by which ghats in the eastern part of India? Correct. Eastern ghats. And which coast will receive maximum rainfall? which coast will receive maximum rainfall? कोस्ट का नाम लिखो, कोस्ट का नाम। ईस्टर्न कोस्ट तो बहुत ह्यूज है ना, फ्रॉम तमिलनाडु टू वेस्ट बंगाल, ओरिसा। दैट पर्टिकुलर कोस्ट का नेम इन तमिलनाडु। करेक्ट राजवी, आंसर इज कोरोमंडल कोस्ट। परफेक्ट, क्लियर। सो इन शॉर्ट वी कैन से देर आर फोर सीजन्स इन इंडिया, द हॉट वेदर सीजन, सीजन ऑफ रेनफॉल, सीजन ऑफ रिट्रीटिंग मॉनसून एंड द कोल्ड वेदर सीजन। वी कैनॉट राइट समर विंटर, we have to follow this. Okay, this was climate of India. Moving ahead to climate of Brazil. Since Brazil has a vast latitudinal extent, in different parts of Brazil the climate will be different. For example, first tell me which winds will cause rainfall in Brazil. Which winds will cause rainfall in Brazil? Two winds hai, southeast trade winds and northeast trade winds. Perfect. Now look at this, southeast trade winds, they will get obstructed by which physiographic division? Southeast trade winds will get obstructed by which physiographic division? The great escarpment, giving rise to which type of rainfall? Perfect, orographic rainfall. Acha, eastern coast mein orographic rainfall, high rainfall, but dash part of the Brazilian highland becomes a rain shadow region. The dash part of Brazilian highland becomes a rain shadow region. Correct. North eastern part. And iska naam kya hai? Drought quadrilateral. Amazing. On the other hand, look at this. Northeast trade winds, they go to Amazon River basin. Here there is rainfall every single day, which is called equatorial type of climate. Har roz barish hota hai. Right? Amazon River basin, called as convectional rainfall. Correct. So here, firstly, this place is nearby the equator, so the temperature will be high. Plus, due to the extreme heat on the surface of the earth, rainfall occurs every day and the rainfall is more than 2000 millimeter. Clear everyone? Climate of India and climate of Brazil. Abhi isme se map marking mein kya kya aayega? Question can be winds that bring rainfall to India. Southwest monsoon wind. Winds that bring rainfall to Brazil, dono mark karna padega. Northeast trade winds bhi, southeast trade winds bhi. Ya fir aa sakta hai, mark the drought prone region in Brazil. So you will have to mark drought quadrilateral. Okay, these are the possible few questions from this chapter. Political map aayega Keshav, so don't worry. No Soham, no. Any queries here in chapter number 4? Yes, Neha, you can post the query in the chat box quickly. Dot quadrilateral, Aryan, beta, it is not near the escarpment. We say it is to the northeastern part of Brazilian highland. It is to the northeastern part of Brazilian highland. Outline map. Sujit, is called political map, okay? No, we will not use color pencils. For map marking, we will use normal gray, black pencils, jo bhi aap usko bolte ho. Normal pencil. No using pen or colored pencil for graph or for map. Outline map, Soham, political map. Is there any query related to chapter 4? General queries jo hai last mein main sort out karungi. Filhal chapter 4 se koi query hai kisi ko? Southwest monsoon wind, Sudiksha. Perfect. Moving ahead, chapter number. No, Mohammed, no. Sharon, which table? You will have to be specific, Sharon, please. Till then, I'm moving ahead. All right, chapter number 5, natural vegetation and wildlife. Okay, vegetation everywhere will be different depending on dash. Vegetation, type of vegetation will keep on changing depending on dash. Rainfall, perfect. Okay, so when we talk about natural vegetation in India, there are 5 types of vegetation. Kaun se 5 vegetation hai? Which are the 5 types of vegetation? Evergreen forest, deciduous forest, thorny shrub vegetation, coastal forest, and Himalayan forest. Okay, let us start with the very first one. Evergreen forest. Rainfall kitna chahiye? More than dash millimeter? Perfect. 2000 millimeter. Since the rainfall is very high, the leaves here will be dash and dash. Broad and green, perfect. Now the type of wood is hardwood, heavy and durable. Correct? And the examples are mahogany, rosewood, and rubber. This is evergreen forest. If you see dark green color mein map pe bataya hai, it can be found in areas which has high rainfall, especially near the coastal areas of India. Next, deciduous forest. Light green color mein dikhaya hai. Here, if you see the amount of rainfall required is less. It is 1000 millimeter to 2000 millimeters. Jia, you can refer the textbook for the same video. Okay, 1000 millimeter to 2000 millimeters. Now, what is the specification of this type of forest is that during summer season, generally, water from the leaves will start getting evaporated. Aur agar pani evaporate ho gaya, matlab trees ko water nahi milega. So, just before summer season, what happens is the roots of the trees they start absorbing all the water from the leaves, due to which evaporation ke process se water will not be lost. Right? And the examples of these deciduous forests, that is the trees found here, are teak, bamboo, banyan, and peepal. These are the four examples. Harshil, during summer or just before summer, water from the leaves will be absorbed by the roots. So that later on, due to evaporation, leaves se pani loss nahi ho jayega. Varna pani milega hi nahi na roots ko summer season mein. Isiliye summer ke pehle roots sare pani ko absorb kar leta hai. That is the, you know, characteristic of deciduous trees. Clear everyone? Evergreen and deciduous kiya humne. Next aata hai thorny shrub vegetation marked in grey color. In, you know, it can be found in areas which has less than 500 millimeters of rainfall. Now obviously, if the rainfall is less, the leaves are going to be very small in size. The leaves will be small in size. Okay, the examples given are, we have cashew, acacia, khejri, cactus. For example, we have aloe vera and agave. These are the examples of thorny shrub vegetation. If you see, it can be found in parts of Gujarat, Rajasthan, in the northern hilly regions, as well as in the northeastern parts of India. Khejri, khejri, one and the same, Sharon. You can write either of the spelling. Both are correct. All right. Then we have Himalayan forests, which depend on the altitude of the mountain. I repeat, it depends on the altitude of the mountain. So at the highest altitude, we find seasonally flowering trees. Then mid altitude, we find coniferous trees, that is cone shaped trees. And at the foothills, we have mixed forest, that is a mixture of coniferous as well as deciduous trees. The examples here are pine, deodar, fir, and sal. These are the examples of Himalayan forest. Then we have coastal forest. Kahan pe milega? In areas where the amount of rainfall is high. So anywhere which, where you find swamp, estuaries, lagoons, or saline soil, here you find coastal forest, also called as mangroves. Coastal forest can also be called mangroves. In India, they are found in Sundarbans, that is in West Bengal. Clear? Yahan ka characteristic of the wood. Evergreen mein kya tha characteristic? Since the rainfall is very high, it was hardwood, heavy and durable. Yahan pe, it is oily, light and durable. Clear? This was natural vegetation of India. Any doubt in natural vegetation? Perfect. Now, when we talk about wildlife, there can be a lot of questions which can come for map marking. Say for example, Assam mein kaun se animals milte? So we have one horn, rhinos, right? Or they can ask us to shade Himalayas or shade the mountains where snow leopards and yaks are found. Or, you know, in objective, they can ask us questions like, which country out of India and Brazil, we can find both tigers as well as lions, right? These are the types of questions that can be framed from India's wildlife, right? So I'm going to tell one part of the question, the answer you will give. I'm okay if you look at the answer and then type, but please make an effort of typing the answer. Elephants are found in which forests? Elephants are found in which forests? Correct, hot and humid forest. Then we have one horned rhinos, which are found in which state? Correct, Assam. Then we have wild ass and camels found in arid lands. Snow leopards and yaks are found in snow-capped regions of Himalayas. Correct. Which is the only country in the world where we find both tigers and lions? Hamara country, India. Then we have sea animals, that is turtles, crocodiles, and gharials, which are found in rivers, estuaries, and coastal areas. Birds ke examples, which are found in forests and wetlands, we have peacock, Indian bustard, kingfisher, pheasants, ducks, parakeets, crane, and pigeon. These are the examples of birds. Now, we all know that due to the increasing pollution and population, a lot of animals and birds and vegetation species are endangered, right? Especially because of poaching. Poaching is nothing but illegal smuggling of animal skin and teeth, right? Rapidly occurring deforestation. इंसान बढ़ रहे हैं तो उनके रहने के लिए फॉरेस्ट को काटते हैं ताकि रेजिडेंशियल फॉर यू नो कॉम्प्लेक्सेस जिसको कॉन्क्रीट जंगल बोलते हैं वो बना सके. सो टू प्रोटेक्ट द वाइल्ड लाइफ ऑफ इंडिया एंड ब्राजील बोथ इन फैक्ट देर आर मेनी नेशनल पार्क वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरीज बर्ड सेंचुरीज एंड बायोस्फियर रिजर्व विच आर इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ India, right? So this was about wildlife of India. I'm quickly moving ahead to natural vegetation in Brazil. In the end, I will take doubts of this chapter. Okay, natural vegetation in Brazil. Again, we have a few types of vegetation. So, kaun se vegetation milte hai Brazil mein? We have equatorial forest, tropical grasslands, swampy land. Hot deciduous forest, thorny shrubs, and temperate grasslands. These are the types of vegetation that are found in Brazil. Right? We know that as we move away from the equator, the number of rainy days and the amount of rainfall, will it increase or decrease? Perfect. It will decrease amount of rainy day as well as, sorry, amount of rainfall and number of rainy days, both will decrease. Right now, we know equator pe we have convectional rainfall, that is rainfall throughout the year. But yahan pe kaun sa type of vegetation milega at the equator? What type of forest or vegetation can you find near the equator? Correct, evergreen forest. Or also called as equatorial forest. Perfect. But if the amount of rainfall decreases, we are not going to find evergreen forest throughout Brazil. राइट. सो जैसे ही बारिश कम हो गया द टाइप ऑफ वेजिटेशन विल ऑल्सो चेंज. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ एवरग्रीन फॉरेस्ट नाउ यू विल फाइंड शॉर्ट श्रब्स, थॉर्नी वेजिटेशन एंड ग्रासेस. राइट. द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ ट्रीज फाउंड इन ब्राजील आर पाओ ब्राजील विच इज अ लोकल वुड. इसी वुड के यू नो बेसिस पे ब्राजील का नाम आया था. देन वी हैव रबर, महोगनी एंड रोसवुड. अदर देन दीज ट्रीज दे ऑल्सो हैव अ वाइड वराइटी ऑफ ऑर्किड्स. हियर देर इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट गिव रीजन विच इज एमेजॉन रेन फॉरेस्ट इज कॉल्ड एज लंग्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. ओके. सो फर्स्ट पॉइंट विल बी Amazon River Basin receives dash type of rainfall. Amazon River Basin or Amazon Rainforest receives dash type of rainfall. Convectional type of rainfall, correct. Which means it receives rainfall every single day. Here, the type of vegetation found is evergreen forest. Perfect. These evergreen forests release a large amount of dash. These evergreen forests release a large amount of dash oxygen, reducing the level of perfect carbon dioxide, and hence it is called as lungs of the world. Clear? Moving ahead, wildlife in Brazil. In the swampy areas of Pantanal, we find anacondas. Then throughout Brazil, you have a large variety of animals like guinea pigs, crocodiles, alligators, monkeys, pumas, as well as leopards. The marine life of Brazil is also quite colorful. So in the sea, we find swordfish, whereas in the rivers, we find pink dolphins and piranhas. There are a variety of birds in Brazil. So we have condors, parrots, macaws as well as flamingo. तो यहाँ पे question आता है, a bird in Brazil which is large in size and flies high in the sky. Answer is condor. Correct. It is not flamingo. No. It is condor. Other than this, it also has millions of varieties of insect. ऐसा बोला जाता है कि ब्राजील में you know the most or the largest variety of animals, birds and insects के species are found in the country of Brazil. That is exactly what I'm talking about, Aditya. It is a vast country with different types of natural vegetation, which is a habitat to a large number of animals, birds, as well as insects. Okay. But here again, there was problem of illegal smuggling of wild animals. Deforestation hota tha, matlab pedon ko kaat dete the, logon ke rehne ke liye. And another problem faced here was slash and burn agriculture, which is called as roka. Right? Quickly explaining what is slash and burn agriculture. Here, the tribal people would, you know, cut down trees and they would burn that area, then use it for agriculture. Then when once the fertility of the soil is lost, they will again move somewhere else and repeat the same procedure. Right? This is called slash and burn agriculture, which was also a major problem in Brazil's wildlife. Right? So this was chapter number 5. Gia, I guess you wanted to see one of the animals. I can't remember what your query was, but this is the map. Just check it out once. No, Devansh, no. So it can be one horned rhinos or something like that. Nothing from here, okay? Equatorial forest, tropical grasslands, swampy lands, hot deciduous forest, thorny shrub and temperate grasslands. Okay, Krish? Yes, Dhwani, yes. Katinga is the name of the vegetation found in drought quadrilateral. Place ka name drought quadrilateral. Wahan pe thorny shrub, Katinga. Soham, please don't get confused. Got it? Perfect. Can we move ahead to chapter number 7? Sorry, 6. Any queries in chapter number 4 and 5? Golden Quadrilateral beta ek project hai, transportation of roadway ka. That is not drought quadrilateral, Rajvi. The Golden Quadrilateral will be connecting the 4 metropolitan cities. So Aditya, Drought Quadrilateral is just a part, small part. Katinga is huge. So accordingly, you'll have to mark it. Yes, you can. That's not a problem. Chalo. Moving ahead, starting with population. India ranks dash in the world in population. Second, perfect. And what about Brazil? What about Brazil? It ranks 5th in the world. Correct. What is the population of India according to 2011 census? Population of India according to 2011 census. 121. Crores. And population of Brazil according to 2010 census? 19 crores. Perfect. But sadly, the land area of India is very less. It is only 2.41% of the world. And the land area of Brazil is 5.6%. So, isse kya ho gaya? India ka land area world ranking kaun se number pe aata hai? 7th in the world. And Brazil becomes 5th in the world. Now, if you look at this, the land area of India is very less, but the population is very high. Because of which the population density, what is density of population? It is number of people living in 1 square kilometer. So India mein jagah kam hai, log zyada hai. So people living in 1 square kilometer also increases. Right? So what is the average population density of India? It is 382 persons per square kilometer. On the other hand, Brazil mein, it is 23 persons per square kilometer. Right? This is about population. But we also have to understand which are the states having a high population density and low population density. Right? As a distinguish hum karenge ye. So India mein states having high population density, we have UP, Bihar, West Bengal, Kerala, and Andhra Pradesh. You have to remember at least any three names after which you can write, etc. Any three names after which you can write, etc. Right? So UP, Bihar, side by side yaad reh jata hai. Kerala and Andhra Pradesh, both are in the south. So you can very well remember these two as well. Right? In Brazil, we have the states of Sao Paulo, Minas Gerais, and Rio de Janeiro, which has high population density. States in India with low population density, we have Arunachal Pradesh, Mizoram, Himachal Pradesh. And in Brazil, we have Para, Oraima, and Amazonas. All right. Here comes an important concept regards to population, which is population growth rate. For example, from 2010 to 2011, for example, India ka population 10 logo se bada. 2011 aur 2012 mein India ka population 7 logo se bada. Is the population still increasing every year? Is the population still increasing? Yes. But the rate at which the growth was happening. Pehle jahan 10 log zyada ho rahe the, aaj wahan pe only 7 people increase. So the rate at which the population is growing, has it increased or decreased? Perfect. It is decreasing. On the other hand, in Brazil, population as well as population growth rate, both are declining. It is said that probably in the next 20 years, agle 20 saal mein, Brazil ka population zyada badhne wala nahi hai. Isliye to bolte hai, India is a young country. Population of youth is high. But Brazil mein, existing population is becoming older and older. So the population of old citizens is higher in Brazil. All right. Correct. Now life expectancy. There's thoda interchange ho gaya hai. So the life expectancy of India is 68 years. Sorry. And the life expectancy of Brazil is 75 years. In India, Aryan, population increase ho raha hai, but the growth at which the population was increasing or the speed at which the population was increasing, wo kam ho gaya. Okay? So life expectancy in India it is 68 years and in Brazil it is 75 years. Literacy in India percentage 72.2% and in Brazil it is 92.6%. And lastly, the sex ratio. What is sex ratio? Number of female per 1,000 males. So the sex ratio of India is 940 females per 1,000 male and in Brazil it is 1080 females per 1000 males. मतलब ब्राजील में फीमेल ज्यादा है और इंडिया में मेल ज्यादा है, राइट? यू कैन स्टार्ट आस्किंग योर क्वेरीज फॉर चैप्टर नंबर 6. नो सोहम, नो, दीज आर स्टेट्स विथ मीडियम पॉपुलेशन डेंसिटी, नेदर इट इज वेरी हाई नॉर वेरी लो. Not necessary Aditya, but match the column में ये सब आने का chances है. हाँ, literacy का percentage, life expectancy का years, ये objectives में आ सकता है, तो आपको ये याद रखना होगा. True or false, match the column. From this chapter you have basic graphs ना, sex ratio वाला graph है वाले chapter पे, या literacy वाला graph है, life expectancy वाला graph है, जो textbook में दिया बेटा वही है. Line graph, yes Mohammed, line graph. Same data can also be asked as bar graph. सिर्फ difference क्या रहेगा, वहां पे line draw कर रहे थे, यहाँ पे bars draw करने होंगे. It can be changed, right? But data will remain the same. Okay, any queries here in chapter number 6?